Sarah Huckabee Sanders unleashes firestorm on liberal reporter who twists Trump's words. There is a constant effort from the left to demonize and delegitimize President Donald Trump. Proving just that is a liberal reporter who decided to twist the president's words in a question for White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders, but too bad for him. That's about the time she unleashed a brutal firestorm that would send him scurrying away with his tail between his legs. Despite their desperate attempts, liberals have been unable to oust President Trump from office thus far. Sadly, all that means is that their best ideas have been used up, and now, they're implementing their second-rate and, frankly, pathetic tactics at this point. Proving that most recently was Jordan Fabian, a reporter for The Hill, who decided to square off against Press Secretary Sanders. Unfortunately for him, the best weapon he had in his arsenal was to twist Trump's words in hopes of catching her in an aha moment, but things spectacularly backfired. As it turns out, Sarah Huckabee Sanders was ready for the attack and went on the defensive right away, unleashing a brutal firestorm on the unsuspecting reporter. For a little context, it all started when Trump released a tweet explaining that the New York City terrorist was allowed into the country under a diversity visa program that was brought about by Democrats. The terrorist came into our country through what is called the Diversity Visa Lottery Program, a Chuck Schumer beauty, President Trump wrote. I want merit-based. For reasons unknown, Fabian got it into his head that this was Trump's way of placing blame for the 8 dead and many more injured directly in Chuck Schumer's lap, a reality that his question to Sanders would more than demonstrate. Regarding Senator Schumer, can you tell us when is the last time he and the president spoke? Fabian mused before trying to pervert Trump's words. And, more broadly, the president saying, Schumer, is responsible, at least, in part for this attack. Does the president see him as someone? Dash, but that's when he was interrupted. Not allowing the man's attempt to go any further, Sanders interjected to put him in his place. Before you go any further, let me be really clear, the president does not blame Senator Schumer and doesn't feel that the senator is responsible for the attack, Sanders began. We believe very strongly that the individual who carried out the attack is responsible and no one else. However, we do think that there are policies that could be put in place that help protect American citizens. We have been talking about those for a long time and we continue to advocate for those policies. The left sure has a knack for trying to spin something that really doesn't need any spinning. For some reason, they've made it an art when it comes to the NYC terrorists, lying about everything from the man's skin color and what the jihadist said while carrying out his attack to who Trump blames for the loss of life. At the end of the day, this terrorist is a monster who needs to be locked away for the rest of his life. However, liberals would rather use the situation as a chance to bash Trump by twisting his words rather than condemn the terrorist for an inarguable act of evil and, more importantly, focus on how others like him can be prevented from doing the same. Liberals may want to think twice before trying to take words out of context because they could just end up looking like a fool, just as Fabian did here. However, it gets worse as it actually looks like they're trying to excuse a terrorist and disrespect the lives lost in their attempt to make a political statement. It makes them look weak, pathetic, and downright un-American.